Hi friends, how are you? I hope all are good. This situation, we can't come to the school because of corona. So we have to make the one plan. We have to make the online classes for the 10th standard students. So I am making for 10th standard mathematics subjects. In your classes, in your syllabus, there are 15 chapters there. I am making first chapter, real numbers. So before going to real numbers, we have to discuss type of numbers. We know that in the last classes, in the last previous years, 9th, 8th, 7th, numbers is what you have to learn in the first chapter only in your textbook. So first number, natural number. What is a natural number? So natural number, we know that accounting numbers are called as natural numbers. So for example, 1, 2, 3, so on. So infinite numbers. So there are these called as natural numbers. The next one, the whole number. So whole number represented by the letter W, natural number represented by the letter N. The whole number means the number, counting numbers along with zero. So therefore it is called as whole number. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Dear students, every natural number or a whole number, but every whole number natural number, because 0, it having only the whole number, but it does not have in the natural number set. Therefore, every natural number are called as whole number. The next one, integer. Integer represents the letter I or Z. I or Z. So what is means integers? Integers means the positive numbers and negative number along with 0, that is called as integers. For example, 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on, and then minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. Except that having positive integers and negative integers along with 0. So therefore, this number is called as integers. The next, rational number. Rational number represented the letter Q. So what does it mean about rational numbers? Rational numbers means a number is in the form of P by Q. Where P and Q are any integers, but Q is not equal to 0. It's a very important condition. P by Q, the number is in the form of P by Q, and where P and Q are any integer, whether it is a positive integer or negative integer, but Q is not equal to 0. That type of numbers are called as rational numbers. For example, 3 by 5. 3 by 5 is one of the rational numbers because 3 is a P and 5 is Q. So 3 and 5 are the 3 by 5 is in the form of P by Q. Therefore, this is called as rational number. Another example, minus 3 by 2. Minus 3 is a negative integer and 2 is a positive integer. Minus 3 by 2 is also a rational number. And then 0. 0 is also a rational number because nothing is there means 1 is there. Therefore, 0 by 1 is also a rational number. But 1 by 0? No, 1 by 0 is not a rational number because here Q is equal to 0. Our condition is Q is not equal to 0. If it is in the denominator 0, it is not a rational number. It is irrational numbers. Next. Irrational numbers. So what does it mean about irrational numbers? Irrational numbers means a number does not form in the form of P by Q, P formal equal. For example, and Q is not equal to 0, same condition. For example, root 3, root 5, root 7, root 8, so on. For example, root 4. I am taking root 4. Root 4 is not an irrational number because root 4, what is the simplest form of root 4 is 2. 2 is a P by Q form. Therefore, it is a rational number. Therefore, root 4 is not an irrational number. Every perfect square numbers are not an irrational numbers. Is a rational numbers. So real numbers means a set can contain every rational numbers and irrational numbers. A set can contain 3 by 4, minus 1 by 2, and 5, 0, root 3, root 5, 5. So these are called as real numbers. Real numbers means a set can contain every rational numbers and irrational numbers. Then it is called as real numbers. So next. Lemma. So what is mean about Euclid division? Lemma or algorithm? Lemma or algorithm. So Euclid, one of the mathematician, he introduced the one concept for finding the HCF. So I am taking example, A and B are any two integers, any two positive integers. Positive integers, there exists their unique cube. A and B are any positive integers, they are unique cube, they are exist. It satisfies A is equal to B cube plus R, where R is greater or equal to 0, less than B. So, what is A is equal to B cube plus R? We know that A and B, when A is greater than B, when A is greater than B, it satisfies, it exists A is equal to B cube plus R. So for example, A, we have to divide it from B. Sorry. A is greater than B. B is divided from A. So if we divide B, this is called as quotient, then remaining is remainder. Then it is in the form of A is equal to B cube plus R. We know that in the 4th, 5th standard. So, verification of division. How you are calculating, how you are verifying the division sums? You know that this is called as dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. So, dividend, it is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So dividend here, B. B is equal to A cube plus R. When B is greater than A. When A is greater than B, A is equal to B cube plus R. And when B is greater than A, B is equal to A cube plus R. Both are same. Okay, next. In the next classes, this is one last question. They are asking one last question. Euclid division lemma statement. So what is that Euclid division lemma? A and B are any positive integers where A and B are they are unique cube. It exists. A is equal to B cube plus R where R is greater than or equal to 0 or less than B. For example, 3 is divided from 5. 3 ones are 3. So 5 minus of 3, 2. So 5 is equal to, I am writing in the form of A is equal to B cube plus R. 5 is equal to 3 and 1. You have to multiply that and the product you should add to the remainder. 3 into 1 plus remainder what? 2. So 5 is equal to 3 into 1 plus 2 is in the form of A is equal to B cube plus R. Okay, time is to answer.